रोजा जाने में तू दिल की धड़कन तुझ बिन तरसे
And then more recently, Lahari Music acquired the music rights of the film called KGF starring Yash, which was made in four South Indian languages. Towards the end of the 1980s, again, an unknown star who had acted in one movie before called BV Hoto Aisi, Tarachand Barjatya's son, Suraj Barjatya, made a movie under the banner of Rajeshree Movies. HMV snapped up the music rights at a very low price and then reaped a bonanza of profits. Of course, all of you know the movie. Who was the music director? Who said that? Yes, please give him. It was the music director's name was Ram Lakshman, not Jatin Lalit. Okay. This took us to the 90s, and Gulshan Kumar's factory tied up with Mahesh Bhatt. Gulshan Kumar had launched a concept called Music Bank. He used to buy tunes from music directors and keep them in his store for using later in movies. This proved helpful when he launched his partnership with Mahesh Bhatt. This was followed by other movies like Dil Hai Ke Manta Nahi, Sadak, and another company called Venus came out with a Super 8 cassette of a movie called Sajan, which was directed by Lawrence D'Souza. Yash Raj films started gaining prominence. Yash Chopra, who had temporarily slipped in the 80s.
Jadu teri nazar, khushbu.
A role which was rejected by Ajay Devgan and Amir Khan went to a youngster and his career got made with that film. It was none other than King Khan, Shah Rukh Khan, who got the villain's role in Dar. Okay, and it made Sunny Deol so angry that he swore never to work with Yash Chopra again, because the climax scene was changed without his consent. That last dialogue where Shah Rukh Khan comes momentarily to consciousness and says something like, I forget the exact words, main bura aadmi nahi hu, main sirf tumhare pyar mein pagal ho gaya tha. That was not in the script shown to Sunny Deol, which was why Sunny Deol boycotted the premiere and never worked with Yash Chopra again. And Yash Chopra came up with another hit 2 years later.
To ye jana sanam प्यार होता है दीवाना सनम तुझे देखा तो ये जाना सनम
So these were the two hit movies that brought Yash Chopra back into the reckoning. Both the music rights went to HMV and HMV made very good profits out of these. Can anyone tell me who composed the music for, not this, here, Dar? Excellent. She deserves a chocolate. Shiv Hari is the acronym of the classical musicians Shiv Kumar Sharma and Hari Prasad Chaurasia. Shiv Kumar Sharma plays Santur and Hari Prasad Chaurasia is famous on the flute. They used to compose film music only for Yash Chopra under the acronym of Shiv Hari. Okay, so both these rights went to HMV. And then you had one more song inspired by the West, which again became very popular.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. I'm sure everybody knows the movie. Who sang it? Yes. You had been long denied, I think, a chance. This time you got it. Sudesh Bonsle, the voice of Amitabh Bachchan, sang it. Again, the music rights were with HMV. And then Jo Jeeta Wahi Sikandar, which was made by Mansoor Khan. Very strangely, he dropped Anand Milind after the success of Kayamat Se Kayamat Tak and took Jatin Lalit as the music directors and still came up trumps. HMV had two more hits during this decade. Hum Aapke Hain Kaun, Rajeshri Pictures and Yash Chopra's Dil To Pagal Hai. There was another peculiar phenomenon in the 90s. Two movies, films flopped very badly. Music sold over 3 million copies each. Yes, which was the movie? Yes, R.D. Burman's way of proving to the world that class is permanent, although form may be temporary. He used only instruments from the 1940s and came up trumps, but sadly was not around when the Filmfare Awards gave this song the best song because he had passed away by then. And also Dil Se was a flop with Venus, but the music sold like hotcakes. Venus also got into the film production business, you know, like Gulshan Kumar and Tips. They too got into the film production business and came up trumps with a very big musical thriller. As I said, chartered accountants have an excellent knowledge of music, so you have preempted my question. They also had a film called Dhadkan, which they produced, which also became a very big musical hit. Western, a company called Western, they too got into the business of acquiring audio rights. They acquired the rights of Yash Johar's Agnipath. Yash Johar was the father of Karan Johar under the banner of Dharma Productions. He was earlier production controller with Devanand's Nauketan in films like Jewel Thief, Prem Pujari, etc. before venturing into film production with the film called Dostana in 1982, starring Amitabh Bachchan and Shatrughun Sinha. Okay? And there was one more movie, very popular, which Western acquired the music rights. So both the films, the music rights were with the company called Western. Tips got into the business, a person called Ramesh Taurani, and he paid a record royalty then, advance payment of rupees 1 crore to Subhash Gai for the music rights of Khalnayak. 5 years later, he again paid a record advance royalty payment of 5 crores to Subhash Gai for the music rights of but was able to recover his investment since both the films became musical hits. 1996, a new label called Sony Music came in. Anyone? Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. After the failure of Duplicate, the music of Duplicate failed, which Karan Johar had given the rights to HMV, so he switched to Sony Music for Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, and it became a big hit, and Sony Music earned good money. This takes us to the last phase, the new millennium. Currently, HMV is known as Saregama India. The label has changed. That was the original design. Now the design is this way. And EMI, which is the parent of HMV. EMI exited India, giving all the HMV music titles to Saregama. And EMI has been taken over by Universal Music Group, which was once their main rival. So Universal has become the largest music group in the world. Yash Raj Films has gone into their own music label. They are now not only into film production and distribution, but they are making their own cassettes and records. I mean, not cassettes and records now. They are making, of course, CDs and etc. and selling them. They have recruited Sanjeev Kohli, who is the son of music director Madan Mohan, as their president. So all their songs, Veer Zara, Dhoom 3, etc., they are now selling under the Yash Raj label. Online music with Napster, Apple Music and Spotify, now from analog, we have moved to digital. HMV stores, 127 stores in UK were in danger of closure, but just last week, Sunrise Records of Canada have purchased 100 of those stores, and they have assured that they are confident of turning around the stores into profit making within 1 year. Can anyone guess what does this advertisement by Amul signify? You know, they have thematic advertisements, you know. For example, when the cricketer Zahir Abbas was scoring runs by the torrents, when India went to Pakistan in 1978, they came out with the advertisement, Zahir Abbas, you know, for Zahir Abbas. So they always come out with, excellent, he deserves a chocolate, the closing of the iconic Rhythm House music store in Bombay. That's why it said no rhythm, just blues. Okay, that was a tough one. The highest advance royalty paid to date for the music rights of a single film, Bhushan Kumar and Kishan Kumar paid 20 crores to Rajashree Productions for the music and ringtone rights of the film Prem Ratan Dhan Payo. Now, T-Series has almost 50% of the market. Most of the other companies are cautious about buying film music rights because either they become big hits or big flops. They never have a middle path. Saregama is trying to combine modern technology with old world charm by coming out with a product called Caravan. It is a Bluetooth speaker designed like a radio and carries about 7,000 songs. So it is intended to give the old world charm and appeal to people who still value the old world of music. Indian music has become an expression of Indian soft power. As Anne Morcom says, Indian film music is an expression of India's soft power. Even in the most distant lands, you will find people singing Hindi film music, as you can see here. You may say nothing unusual about the song, but the point is this is in Uzbekistan and the person singing it is a person named Babo Murad Hamdordov. Okay, so he's from Uzbekistan singing a Hindi song, film song, without referring to the lyrics. This is a walking encyclopedia in music. His name is V.A.K. Rangarao. Any of you go to Madras, I've given his address and phone number. You can take, if you're interested, you can visit his house. He's having the largest collection in India of over 53,078 RPM records. You know, records are normally of three speeds, 78 RPM, 45 RPM, and 33 1/3 RPM. RPM is revolutions per minute. So he has India's largest collection of over 53,078 RPM records, and he has several times written to the music companies to correct mistakes made by them while giving the facts as to singers, lyricists, and music directors on their labels. This is the bibliography which I have referred in putting together this presentation. These are all authoritative books on Indian film music and the Indian film industry. Most of them are available on Amazon. So as we come towards the close, I had one question remaining. It slipped my mind. Let me just ask. I hope chocolate is there. One last question. Okay. When we spoke about Mohammad Rafi's domination in the 1950s and 60s, I pointed out that Mohammad Rafi sang for Kishore Kumar in 5 films, right? But towards the end of the 60s and the turn of the 70s, there were 2 songs which were separately sung The same song in two versions, one version by Mohammad Rafi, one version by Kishore Kumar. Can anyone tell me which are the two songs? Excellent. Nasir Hussain's Pyar Ka Mausam 1969, Tum Bin Jao Kaha, sung by both Mohammad Rafi and, yes, the second one. That was one song, two different characters. It was like a group song, but the same song separately sung. Want a clue? 1971, produced by G.P. Sippy, directed by Ramesh Sippy, music Shankar Jaikishan, lyrics Hasrat Jaipuri, starring Shammi Kapoor, Hema Malini and Rajesh Khanna in a special role. Yes, madam, you are right. It is Andaz, the song Zindagi Ek Safar Hai Suhana. So as we come to the end of my presentation, you see the music industry of India has traveled right from, you know, lac to polyvinyl chloride. We call them vinyl records, you know, and down to cassette, CD and analog has given way to digital. But interestingly, last year in the US, 17 million vinyl records were sold. So now slowly the cycle is coming back. Retro is becoming cool. But then, you know, as somebody said about the Indian film music industry, 25 years back, it took two music directors to give good music. Now it takes 8 music directors for a single film to give not so good music, you know. But then I am always optimistic because, you know, I remember the 1980s always, you know, when all kinds of lyrics and all kinds of music was coming in, it seemed that there is no savior for the Hindi film music industry. At that time, like a whiff of fresh air, Anand Milind came along with Kayamat Se Kayamat Tak. So I am always optimistic that the best is yet to come. So we will again have a golden era where the next Rafi, the next Kishore or the next Mukesh will once again remind us of what the Indian film music industry is capable of if they make up their mind. Till then, let us remember, and I conclude with this song so that we always remember the golden past.
Yaad na jaye bete dino ki jaake na aaye jo din dil kyun bulaaye unhe.
Thank you very much. That concludes my presentation. Thank you for a very patient hearing. And a special thanks to my colleague and friend, Dr. Binu Mathew, for all the technical support that he has given me. This compilation would not have been possible without all the tracks. I requested him the tracks and he sat and put them together in the appropriate places, because as far as technology is concerned, I am a moron. So he's a wizard. So he has done all the technical gizmo that you see here. Thank you very much.
Please, friends, stay back. Stay back. We will dismiss. We'll take exactly less than 5 minutes. We did have an exciting session, Dr. Rajesh. We would definitely come to you. You being the walking encyclopedia before going to Madras, Chennai to come to meet Mr. Rengarao, and this happens to be one of the most entertaining CPE sessions we had for the past many years. Thank you, Doctor, and have a nice applause. Now, may I welcome Manish to hand over a book quote to Dr. Rajesh. We will have a short thanksgiving by C.A. Ravi. After that, we will have a group photograph. Ravi, please.
Sir, thank you, Dr. Rajesh. I prepared something, but it's coming short. So you have an encyclopedia of music. Thank you very much for this. And since it is a formal, I just want to say formally to His Majesty Sultan Qaboos, thanks. And our sincere thanks to the CBFS for their continued support and sponsoring our ICA Muscat chapter. We thank Dr. Rajesh for interactive session. We thought of change management is a pure music-oriented thoughts, and with so many new things which I learned. Thank you very much, Dr. Rajesh. We wish to thank our volunteers, Mr. Biju, for their support in organizing this event. We further thanks our Mr. Nagesh and Swagat for the snacks. Last but not least, we wish to thank all our past chairmen and our members, managing committee members, for their valued guidance and making this event a success. We look forward to see you in the future events. And as Mr. Bhavani Prasad has told, that we are looking for more members to join and attend our events more proactively. We will be coming up with broadcasting with a new number, wherein we will circulate it to the members. You can just say hi to us, then we'll put you in the broadcasting list of our ICA Muscat chapter, and it will be the information will be flown to you much faster than the email and other communications. Maybe some emails are not being passed on to the members, or may not be willing to see the member emails. So we look forward for your more participation in this. Thank you very much, sir.